Good afternoon, friends. Honorable Pro Vice Chancellor Sir, Professor Irfan Habib Sir, Professor Emeritus in AMU, Professor Talib Sir, and our darling speaker of the day, Teesta Sitalwat. I am privileged to be the first speaker of today's program. This is an honor Parvez Talib Sahib has bestowed on me. The theme is very important. Preamble of the Indian Constitution. The inaugural words of Amin, he said, we have to take sides. Mr. Amin Sahib, we are not taking sides, we are taking the side of the Indian Constitution. We are taking the side of the preamble. We are taking the side of the idea of India, which has been envisaged in the Constitution of India. And the preamble, as in the Constituent Assembly of India, it was discussed, is a soul of the Constitution. It is an Atma. If Atma is not there, the Constitution is dead. If the Constitution is dead, the nation is dead. And this preamble is actually based on the objectives resolution which the first Prime Minister of India, Pandit Nehru, introduced in the Constituent Assembly of India. On 22nd January 1947, much before India got independence, this point should be noted, because this preamble represents the idea of India. What is the idea of India which is incorporated here? That is an inclusive India. That is an India which guarantees freedom of religion to all, especially clause 5th and 6th of this objectives resolution I would like to read. Wherein shall be guaranteed and secured to all people of India justice, social, economic and political, equality of status, everybody will be equal in free India, equality of opportunity before the law, freedom of thought and expression, everyone is free to express oneself, belief, faith, worship, vocation, association and action subject to law and order. Now the next clause is very important, which has actually been reproduced in the preamble from the objectives resolution. It says that we safeguards are provided for the minorities, backward and tribal areas, depressed and other backward classes. Now you see, minorities are there, backward people are there, tribals are there, depressed people are there, and backward classes are there. Each class, each minority has its own idea of India that needs to be protected. And freedom of expression also means you will express in the language you speak or the language which you understand. India is not having one language. In the Constitution, you have many languages recognized. Thousands of languages are spoken here. A Tamilian will speak in Tamil, Kannada person will speak in Kannada. That is, you cannot impose Hindi on everybody. The idea of India, which has been propagated by a particular political party, particular group in India, which is nowadays in power, is trying to impose an idea of India which is exclusive India. One nation, one people, one race, and one language, and one kind of food. You know, that is the idea. Now, during the last 65 years, the Supreme Court of India has, in many judgments, declared that the ideas and visions of India which are propagated in the Constitution, especially in the preamble, form the basic structure of the Constitution. If one of the ideals is compromised, then the structure will collapse. Supremacy of the Constitution is one, that is, you have to respect the Constitution. Republican democratic form of the government is another basic structure reflected in the preamble. Secularism is another idea which has been reflected in the Constitution. Separation of powers and federalism. And how did this idea of India, inclusive, diverse, multicultural, multi-religious, in fact sometimes you can even say multinational India, emerged? Three important rulers contributed for evolving this kind of India. First, it was Ashoka the Great. He was the one who propagated the idea of respect for others' religions, that one should respect the religion of others so that the others will respect your religion. Religious tolerance was propagated by Ashoka the Great. And larger part of India had come under his rule. The second great ruler, Akbar the Great, he ruled for 50 years. He had the policy of religious tolerance. And he did not declare Islam as the state religion. Religion was personal matter, private matter. State was secular. And the third rulers, the British rulers, they also did not interfere in religious matters. Ashoka, Akbar, and the Britishers, all these three rulers were from the minority community. Please remember, they were not from the majority community. It is they who contributed for the evolution of this Akhanda Bharat, because larger part of India was under their rule, for which we all are proud of today. Even Gandhi had said that a civilization is known by the way it treats its minorities. If the minorities are not treated well, with respect, with human rights, with their dignity, then your civilization is not at all a civilization. You know, you have multiple ideas. In fact, I was reading, I will not take much time, in 3-4 minutes I will complete, because the main speaker is Teesta. Everyone has come to listen to Teesta. On Friday afternoon, this much gathering is there. That itself shows, you know, how much everybody likes this idea of India as well as the speaker, Teesta Sitalwad. You know, You cannot have a single kind of idea, one narrative which you want to impose on others. In fact, A.K. Ramanujam said there are 300 Ramayans. Not one Ramayana, there are 300 Ramayans. When we go to Ayodhya, we find 10,000 temples. Not one temple, every temple is claiming that Ram was born there. And calendars, there are 30 calendars in India, not one calendar. That speaks of pluralism, that speaks of multicultural India. And if we want to homogenize India, that is violating the spirit of the preamble of India. Now, let me come to Teesta Sitalwad. She is the valiant lady. She is firmly standing her ground for this kind of inclusive India, multicultural India, multilingual India, federal India. She is protecting human rights, rule of law, democratic values in India. And she is so popular, I had invited her three times earlier, during 2010, 11, and 12. Every time people were not able to get space to sit. because you know she speaks from her heart. When I initiated a fundraising program for her activities, our students collected lot of money and it was given to her. And the very striking point was that three rickshaw pullers also gave their whole day's earning of 80 or 100 rupees. Madam, you are residing in the heart of everyone. 36 inch ke seene mein reside karne ki zarurat nahi hai. You are in the heart of every one of us. And your name speaks Teesta. Teesta is, you know, river in Bangladesh, always flows. She will be, you know, I am sure, standing for this inclusive, multicultural, diverse India. My last point, I already got, you know, slip. I am very conscious of the time, sir. That these days, due to this rising intolerance, many people are returning their awards, started with Sahitya Academy writers of all the languages. Majority of them are Hindus. India is secular. India is surviving not because of Muslims, but because of Hindus. Some people are returning this Padma Shri, Professor Bhargava, scientist. Day before yesterday, many film personalities returned their national awards. And today's newspaper says 50 historians, including Professor Irfan Habib Saab, have signed a statement about their concern for this growing intolerance. I wish I also had some national award to return back. Unfortunately, I do not have any national award. In 2013, I was sent by Government of India to hold India chair in Canada. And that chair cannot be returned because I already occupied the chair and came back. Thank you very much.